Before we meet Negan in the Walking Dead comics, we meet a small group of thugs called the Saviors. Before we meet the Saviors, Rick has to find Jesus. Literally. Let's talk. Who is Negan? A good amount of time passes from when Eric and Aaron find Rick and the survivors and invite them to Alexandria. At Alexandria, they settle in, deal with domestic issues, supply runs, a basic group of thugs tries to attack, internal turmoil, and finally the largest walker herd battle in the history of the comic, leaving many, many people dead, and Carl disfigured for life. Things are quiet, and a man watches from the outside of the gates. He introduces himself and reveals his name is Paul Jesus Monroe, a scout from another community. Jesus takes Rick and company to meet Gregory, the leader of the Hilltop. This is where we discover a madman named Negan and his large group of followers called the Saviors are using old world mafia tactics to extort the communities of half of their supplies in exchange for protection and walker cleanup around the communities. Rick makes a deal to shut down the Saviors and run them out of town in exchange for some much needed food and supplies from the Hilltop, leaving the headquarters of the new allies on the Hilltop. Rick and company run into a small group of Saviors, and they dispatch with them fast, leaving only one man left alive to deliver a message to Negan. The Hilltop is off limits. Rick and company has another skirmish at the Alexandria safe zone, and Rick and a small group leave on a fateful mission to find Jesus at the Hilltop and get some help in combating the Saviors. In the van, unknowingly heading right into Negan's trap, are Rick, Michonne, Carl, Heath, Glenn, Maggie, and Sophia. Before they can even reach the Hilltop, the Saviors have surrounded Rick and company. Negan makes his appearance out of the huge group of Saviors. He lays out the new laws of the land, and he chooses one person to beat to death with his baseball bat covered in barbed wire. And he tells Rick in the most vulgar way possible, Rick now works for him, so forget about ever living in whatever paradise he thought he had in Alexandria. Negan says, we follow rules to keep us alive. We survive, we provide security for others, and we bring back civilization. Back to the world, we are the Saviors. Negan and his men live at the factory. It's actually a factory. The exterior is surrounded by impaled zombies, zombie torsos, zombies chained up from cars, and everything else. It's like Michonne's walker pets. They seem to protect the headquarters by keeping it hidden from other walkers. It also stops invaders from mounting an attack. Inside the factory, not all the people inside are soldiers. There are other survivors. Unluckily to them, they ran into people like Negan, who took them in. The people inside the factory earn points to trade for goods and services. Negan uses this to his advantage, especially to the women. If a woman chooses to become Negan's wife, and he has many, they are dressed in sexy lingerie, and they all live in the same area, like Negan's own personal Playboy Mansion room. These women do not have to earn points for food or survival anymore. They are his. But if they cheat or still associate with a man they were with before Negan, the women choose to stay with Negan or to go back to fending for themselves. If they choose to stay with Negan, the man must be punished. Negan then calls for the iron ritual. A man is tied up and placed in a chair, and a hot iron is held to his face, disfiguring him in shame for the rest of his life. Now, Negan is brutal and foul-mouthed. His sick and twisted sense of humor is frequently aimed at an audience of one, himself. He carries the baseball bat wrapped in barbed wire that he lovingly calls Lucille, which he has an unhealthy affection towards. He is a sociopath, and he always seems to have an addiction to testing people's wills. He gets off on control, but gets off even more when the ones he tries to control struggle and fight him off, a little or a lot, as he inserts himself into their world. Yet, he is against rape. Physical rape, that is. Because, figuratively, he rapes the lives of everyone he comes across, even his own men. Negan will successfully get Rick to follow his orders, but it doesn't last long. Right from the very beginning, Rick was always planning his attack. What happens next leads to bloody battles in this new world, unlike anything we have ever seen so far. The body count will mount on both sides. A safe place will crumble in ruins. Changes will affect these survivors forever. Alliances will be made, and the world of the Walking Dead will be consumed in all-out war.